Okay, so this will be a nice topic, and I hope I can pursue the English language up to the end. Okay, so firstly, why did I make this video? I made this video because I saw on television what it takes to be a great and accomplished ballet dancer. Ballet. B-A-L-L-E-Y. Ballet dancer. Okay? Doing the ballet. Okay? So, the best ballet school in the world. And you can see the children there. Children, take note, children. Their faces are so determined. Determined with full concentration. Focused, that's the term, focused. Focused with determination, grim, G-R-I-M, grim determination. To become a great ballet dancer later. Now, they have to start from a younger age. Okay? Younger age, better dancer. Okay? And they must be disciplined and concentrated in their effort. Okay? So, what's the connection? For those who are in probably college, high school. Oh, by the way, no notes here. Everything is random and impromptu. No notes here. Those who are in high school and college and or college, planning to go to med school, medicine proper. Oh, by the way, there's still no title for this video. Okay, no title yet. For those who are planning to attend med school, med proper, medicine proper, okay, after college, so this is the video for you. Okay, now the connection was with the ballet is that to be in med school, you have to have that grim determination in the child. Take note in the child, huh? In the child. Grim determination to do all what it takes to be a great ballet dancer at that young age in preparation for later years. Okay? So, that's also somewhat like medicine proper. Now, is medicine proper for you or not for you? Okay? The choice will be made in high school and or college. Okay? In high school and or college. Now, the preparation for med school is probably, I'm talking of the now, the present, okay? Not my past, which is eons ago. Not my past. The future of you out there. I think the best decision-making should be made on grade 12. Grade 11, grade 12, grade 12, grade 11. Why? Because I'll just make an example, okay? I just saw a curriculum and the subjects involved. There's a pre-med course. The course title in one university here in the Philippines. Oh, by the way, the topic here is the Philippines. Okay? Philippines. Philippines going to med proper in the Philippines. Okay, now, I saw the the pre-medicine course. The course title is pre-medicine. But slash biology. Okay? Pre-medicine slash biology. Okay? Preparatory to medicine. It's like a biology preparatory to medicine proper. Now, I looked at all the subjects there. It is literally second year medicine proper, preparing you for second year medicine proper. Literally, the subjects there. Okay? So by the time that you will really enter and be in second year med proper, it will just be easy for you. It will just be a review. Totally a review only. So having passed that college, that university, medicine proper will be easy for you if you took that course. Okay? Now having said that, what does it take? Remember the topic ballet dancer? It will take, after college, it will take a person before starting on his first day in med proper. It will take a person, that person should be fully determined to do sacrifices, probably no love life, probably no love life, no dating. If you're a genius, probably you could watch a movie every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks if you're a genius. If you have a great memory, you could watch a movie every 2 weeks, every 1 week. If you have a great memory. So that's a plus if you have a great memory. Medicine proper will be easy for you. Okay? If you have a photographic memory, you remember everything. Okay? That's a plus. Now, so if you're gifted with memory, extreme memory, photographic memory, you're gifted, and medicine proper will be easy for you. Okay? So, but the key factor will be, excepting those having great memory, the key factor will be you are really determined against all odds, against everything. You're really determined and focused to become a doctor. Okay? Determined and focused. Just like the child that I was telling you about. Wanted to be a great ballet dancer in that prestigious school, the number one ballet school in the world. In the world, huh? Ballet school in the world. You can see that first determination in that child. That grit, G-R-I-T, grit and determination and effort. Okay, so that's what you need to be in medicine proper and to finish the course and to become a doctor. You need that. Focused and determined. Focused and determined. Okay? So what are the other things you need? The minor ones will be the prerequisite subjects. Okay? Physics, algebra, that was in my time. Math courses, psychological courses, psychology courses, which are prerequisites. Psychology courses, chemistry courses, mathematics courses, prerequisites. Comparative anatomy course, one subject. It's also a prerequisite, comparative anatomy. Those are all also minor, because you could take those things anytime. Then enter med proper, medicine proper. Passing the entrance exams for medicine proper. Just review and wishing everybody will pass. Okay, so that's also not a major factor. And financial, you could have a sponsor with your good grades. Okay, good grades, you will have a sponsor. Sponsor for your tuition fee. If you are not that rich. Okay, so prerequisite subjects. If you want to have a easy time in med proper, probably you could take that course that which I told you about. It's called a pre-medicine course, pre-medical proper course, medicine proper course, prerequisite medicine proper, / biology course. Okay? That's the best course. I saw the subjects. Literally, it's medicine proper in college. Okay? So, that's the easiest path for medicine proper. Okay? So, your hardship will be in college, not in med proper. Okay? So, sacrifices and you should not fear blood spurting out. You have 1 year of being with a dead corpse, dead body, 1 year. So you must take that. And the most significant will be you're determined to finish the course. Oh, by the way, don't start medicine proper and say to yourself, after one time I'll try it out, if it didn't work out I'll quit. So my point is, don't anymore start it out. You'll be wasting your time if you don't like really being a doctor, okay, and doing all the sacrifices. Okay, it's full of sacrifices. It's 20 times harder than college, except with that pre-med course. Okay, that's the medicine course already taking up in college. You're taking in college, okay? Oh, by the way, if you took that course in college, when you go to medicine proper, it will be easy for you. You're just playing second year. Second year med proper, you will just be like reviewing. You've learned everything already. Everything there is to know. It is just like a review for you, second year. If you took that pre-med course, if you took a psychology course or other courses, you will be like all the rest who had the basic requirements for med proper, and you're all in equal footing. Okay? It all now depends on your determination. Now, we're also required to do a lot of reading. If you're a person who doesn't like to read at least 6 hours a day or more, med proper is not for you. Okay? Because for the first 4 years, you do a lot of reading. For the first 4 years of college, of med proper, we'll do a lot of reading. Take books, 100 pages per day, minimum. you have to read the rate of reading. Also, the font is very small. Font, F-O-N-T. The font is very small. So, 100 pages with the font so small, it's quite a lot. Quite a lot of reading. Okay, and sacrifices you're willing to take? Basically, for the 4 years, you were just reading, reading, and reading. Okay? That's the 4 years of medicine proper. Reading, 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 tons of material, T-O-N-N-E-S, tons of material, tons of pages of reading medicine books. And you must really like to be a doctor, to be able to endure all of those. Endure all of those things. Okay, and those are basically the least you need to be in medicine proper. The least you need. Okay, so probably if you have other topics you like me to discuss, you just mention it below. Okay, on the comment section. Please discuss this, please discuss that. Here in the Philippines, topic is here in the Philippines. Medicine proper here in the Philippines. Okay? For your other questions or maybe topics you like to discuss. Minor things are after graduating from medicine proper, you'll get to know consultants who debase you, D-A-B-A-S-E, debase you, look down on you. It's part of life. You have to get over those things. They will say demeaning words to you. Sometimes they will say you're the lowest form of animal, like that. And you have to get over those things. The reason behind that will be another video. Okay? It will be part of another video. Okay? It's not the concern of this video yet. So probably that's a minor thing, because by that time you have graduated already from med proper. Okay, so, oh, by the way, for those who are poor in memory, poor in memorizing, I passed medicine proper. So perfect memory is not a requirement. I just really love to be a doctor. And I love to read. I love to read the medical books. So I passed medicine. Okay, now. Oh, by the way, listen carefully. If you are being forced by your parents to be a doctor, to take medicine proper, I suggest you do not start and take medicine proper first year. Because you will be in a torture situation. You're just torturing yourself. If you're not interested and your parents are the only ones interested in you becoming a doctor, you're just wasting your time and effort. And you're in a torture situation. I had many classmates like that in torture situations because their parents want them to become doctors. Me, I really like to be a doctor. And I really like to read those tons of medical books. So, it was easy for me. Easy decision. But remember, I don't have that gift of memory. Okay? My memory always fails. So, I get only 74, 75, 74, 75. Only passing grades only. Because my memory fails me. Okay? I'm not that gifted. Okay? But you can still pass if you are really interested in the subject. In medicine proper and becoming a doctor. Okay? So, subscribe and follow. Follow and subscribe.